what's the metric there? Like, how much can they do? They have to lower their cost in order to become more focused on web video and doing more web video, because it seems like their whole, right now you guys benefit from not having to spend money on your development, right? So what's the economics of the video on, let's say, a service like that?
So there's two answers to that. One is, we actually measure ourselves based on monetization per minute of content consumed. And we look at those rates relative to other environments, like living room environments primarily. And so that's really important to us, because we want to be able to talk to the heads of these studios and say, hey, here's the money that you're going to make per minute of content consumed, a lot of which is content that is not even in the living room, like Arrested Development, clips, things like that. And so we measure ourselves based on that. And so, once you get to a very good spot there, and we're very happy where we're at that point, then it's all about volume, which is how many people are actually consuming the content. And at a certain point, it basically comes down to very simply, how much revenue do I think I'm going to generate on a given show? And if the answer is, wow, enough so that I can have a nice profit margin for the content creator and be able to produce a great show, then suddenly you start to see people producing more content for the web exclusively. I still think that it's for the highest sheen, the highest production value stuff, it's going to be living room and web. It's not going to be only web.
Do you guys have any thoughts on the whole network neutrality debate, the major broadband now, you know, cable broadband providers are saying, you know, there's a limit to how much broadband you can use, and it's essentially because of video. So in that kind of situation, that threatens people like Hulu, right? So what's your take on that?
So this is just my personal take. This is not sort of on behalf of any company or whatnot. Is that I'm a big believer in network neutrality. I always have been from my days, you know, prior at Amazon and obviously at Hulu. I just believe that that's sort of the spirit of the internet. Now that said, I know that a lot of the infrastructure companies are investing billions in the broadband infrastructure, and they're going to price it appropriately. But I think it would be a huge mistake to A, not stick with network neutrality, and then also go with pricing that doesn't reflect an all-you-can-eat type situation. And so that's just my own personal belief. I know that there's a lot of smart people that have other opinions, but hey, reasonable people can agree to disagree. Thank you very much.